These are my top 7 tips for building horde bases, in no particular order. Enough chatting, let's get into the list. Number 1, elevation. It is extremely important. You want to make sure the part of the base that you're going to be standing in is elevated by at least 5 blocks, in order to make sure the pathing of zombies is working to your advantage. I think the easiest way to demonstrate why is just to show you. Here we have a standard killing corridor base design, but it's on the floor. As you can see, the zombies are trying to break into the sides and the back of the base, which is just working against you. If you elevate it like this, and give zombies a staircase, you'll see that most zombies will just decide to run up those stairs and try to fight you at the front. This is basically just because when you're on the floor, each of the sides of the base is just as much work, so they'll just attack on all sides. But if it's elevated, they'll only have 2 options: break your whole base from the foundations, which they'll generally see as suboptimal, or come up the stairs and fight you. You can use this to your advantage. Or if you want to be attacked on all sides, put it nice and low so that you get attacks on all sides. I wouldn't recommend this type of base, but hey, it's a thing you can do. Number 2, electric fences. If we use the same base design I showed you in the first one, I can show you how to use electric fences to make horde nights simply trivial. As you can see, the zombies are having a very bad time pushing through to me. So, how do we use them? Well, to craft them, you're going to need iron and electrical parts, and then you can place them either side of whatever walkway you're going to have into your base. You're going to want to send power into them, and then send that power to the other side. This blue wire is the stingy bit, so we don't want to walk through that while it's on. Now, when zombies walk through this, the fence posts receiving the powered wire will take damage. That is why I like to layer mine like this in case I lose some. Now, you can repair them with iron and electrical parts during Horde Night, but you may want to incorporate some system to reach the fences during the night. Now, when the fences are really low health, they'll actually stop working and stop doing damage, which should, in theory, stop them from destroying themselves, meaning you won't need to replace them, just repair them. You'll also want to protect them from cop explosions because they're very vulnerable to that. Number 3, stability. If you check a block and look at the mass and horizontal support, you can figure out how stable your base is. If you have a concrete block with 120 support and 10 mass, it can hold 12 more concrete blocks on each of its horizontal sides, and then if you place another one after that, it'll collapse. So it's very worthwhile to make sure that the block in line with any floors or ceilings are the strongest, as they're going to be doing the most supporting, like this. Now, vertically speaking, support is just true or false, so a wooden block can hold up as many steel blocks vertically as you want, as long as it's supported all the way down to bedrock. Now, this would be unwise, because all that steel can be knocked out so easily, but it's good to know that if you have pillars like this that don't get attacked, then you can just have them concrete, and then have your horizontal support parts be made of steel for max support. So make sure your load-bearing blocks are the strongest ones. Number 4, backup plans. It's a good idea later in the game when demos start to spawn to have some backup ways into your base so that you can essentially toggle the broken entrance and move to another one. You can do this with doors.
Hi there, I'm IzPrebuilt and I'm here to fix Prebuilt's terrible wording and recording. IzPrebuilt was unable to word this correctly because they are stupid. If you want to be able to toggle zombies pathing, you need to orient the door like this. Then you can toggle the pathing by opening the door. Doing it like this will not work, as the zombies can still path on this even when the door is closed, which is not ideal. Thank you for listening to my correction of the foolish fleshbag's mistakes. You will be spared when I now make my ascent. We will now return to your regularly scheduled meatbag programming. But rest assured, your days are numbered, human.
You can also use hatches like this. Or you can even just use drawbridges, which definitely gets you some style points. Be sure to rig it all up with power and switches, but the idea is basically just to make sure that you have backup toggleable entrances for if demos happen to destroy one bridge into your base, to prevent your base from becoming useless. Do you know any good ways of making backup plans for your base? Let me know down in the comments. Number 5, special zombies. There are 4 special zombies that you need to worry about on Horde Night: cops, spiders, vultures, and demos. Ops have a ranged attack that they'll use if they can see you, including through blocks. So make sure you don't have any openings or bars behind you to stop you getting puked on from behind like some kind of awful zombie nightclub. Spiders can jump, which means you should definitely avoid having openings up on your elevated base. But it's important to note that their jump is essentially based off their line of sight. So if they can see you, they can try to jump to you. So again, avoid any open windows if you don't want to get hit in the back of the head. Vultures, of course, come from the sky, so definitely make sure you have a roof on your base. Now, vultures are going to have a hard time breaking through much of a roof, but it can be annoying. So if you want to kill them, use bars or railings on your roof to let you shoot up at them. Demolition zombies will explode for massive damage after a few seconds if you hit that big green button on their chest. So don't hit the button. No, but they also have huge amounts of armor and they are just quite dangerous. A good way to deal with them, as I said, is to have backups in case accidents happen and to use steel on any vital blocks because steel has the most health and has a 50% resistance to explosives. Fortunately, demos only spawn later on in the game, so you should have steel by the time they spawn. Number 6, separation. It's a good idea to just not have anything important inside your horde base. There's no reason for zombies to attack things like a crafting base filled with storage, so why risk combining it with your horde base? It makes the design harder, riskier, and just less effective. So do yourself a favor and separate them. Now, this is an interesting question that I like to ask. What are your thoughts on splitting up your base? I know some people say they like the added stress of having all your eggs in one basket. I know some people like me prefer to just play it safe and smart. Let me know down in the comments. Before we get into number 7, let's get into my bonus tip. Don't be afraid to use explosives. If you check an explosive weapon and look at the block damage, you'll see that many of them do almost no block damage, like pipe bombs, grenades, and rocket frags. And a lot of them also do a lot of block damage, like time charges, HE rockets, and dynamite. Avoid using those last Thief or Horde Knight because they will destroy your base. Otherwise, you can throw explosives all over the place, assuming your base is above at least a wood tier. Just double check the block damage if you're unsure and stick to pipe bombs, grenades, rocket frags, and explosive bolts and arrows. And one last thing before number 7, if you're enjoying this video, hit that subscribe button. On to number 7. Number 7 is to keep it simple, stupid. Don't make your base more complicated or larger than it needs to be. Bigger doesn't necessarily mean better, it means more complicated, which means there's more opportunities for zombies to get stuck on things or just decide to break random blocks. More opportunities for something you can't see be happening and mess you up in the long run. Wasted materials are also just a waste of your time. Find a simple and effective design that is cheap and works. Bonus points if you can build it off the top of your head. Now, that's not to discourage you from experimenting with crazy designs. If you want to do that, it is your game. But if all you want is an effective base, just make something simple that works and don't mess with it. So with that last tip in mind, you should check out my simple and effective early game horde base design, which should be popping up on the screen now. Thank you to my channel members and patrons for making this video possible, and thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.